the tale as old as time. Who has the better budget CPU? Now, is it Team Blue or is it Team Red? To figure it out, I've built two nearly identical budget PCs. The AMD PC costs just $891, and the Intel PC costs $898. To start with, as you can probably tell, they both use the exact same case, which is the Magnium Gear Neo Air, a great case you can get for just $60. And each case has three case fans, two up front and one exhaust fan in the back. Both PCs also have an RTX 4060, 16 gigs of CL16 3600 RAM, a 1 TB SSD, and a 650-watt 80-plus gold power supply. Each CPU is cooled by a single-fan tower air cooler, and each one has four heat pipes. So with the exception of the CPUs, these are nearly identical builds. And lastly, they're both running B-series motherboards, the AMD being a B550, and the Intel being a B760. So what are the differences? AMD is coming in with the Ryzen 5 5600X, which is a 6-core, 12-threaded CPU. The Intel, on the other hand, has a 10-core, 16-thread i5-12600K. Before starting this video, I updated the BIOS, set up XMP with both of these systems, installed Windows 11 Pro, and made sure all the drivers are up to date. So for 2024, let's settle this debate. Who has the best CPU when you're trying to build a PC for just under $900? Tax not included. Since we're focused on the CPU, we're gonna run Cinebench, we'll run the Passmark CPU bench test, and then we're gonna hop into a couple of Warzone games, as well as Counter-Strike 2, to see which CPU is better for you. So let's dive straight into those numbers. All right, so we've completed all the testing. Let's take a look at how these two computers did first in Cinebench. The Intel 12600K came in at 15,231 points for Cinebench, and the Ryzen 5 5600X with its fewer cores and threads came in at 10,772. We kind of expected that just because the Intel has more cores, so that's not really a big surprise. Next, the Passmark CPU test. The Intel came in with 26,627, versus the AMD, which came in at 22,524. So for workstations, the 12600K definitely pulled out. So with those extra cores and threads, the 12600K did beat out the 5600X, but that doesn't necessarily mean it won in gaming. So let's take a look and see how it did in Counter-Strike 2. You can see in these side-by-side videos of the Counter-Strike 2 gameplay that both PCs were averaging the 300 to 330 FPS range, but I was seeing a few dips down below 300 on the Ryzen 5 5600X, more so than we saw on the i5-12600K. So another feather in the cap there for the 12600K. Let's move to the last one. I jumped into a Warzone solos match, landed in the same area of the map with each computer. So let's take a look at the footage and see how the Intel and the AMD compare. First thing that you can notice here is that the average FPS on both systems was pretty similar, all around that 120 to 140 mark. Both systems running at identical resolutions with identical settings. And as we know, they have the same GPU, so it really does just come down to that CPU. The one thing you might notice is the Ryzen 5 5600X did have a couple more stutters than we saw in the 12600K during this game. You'll see that those 1% lows do drop down pretty low compared to the 12600K. However, in the first game we played with the 12600K, the entire server actually was lagging, so that could just be the game and not necessarily the CPU. So in conclusion, both CPUs were able to handle Warzone and Counter-Strike 2 with little issue, almost identical FPS, and pretty similar 1% lows. But with the 12600K being just slightly more expensive and having four additional cores and threads, if you're doing anything that's workstation related or editing, the 12600K is gonna be the CPU. So for now, the winner is Team Blue. If you're interested in getting a PC just like this one, you could go to redneckengineer.com and get your own custom PC made, or check out the full build list down in the description for either of these PCs. They're both great systems, even though the Intel did edge it out in our test today.